Hello and welcome back to my Metallica 72 Seasons journey, everybody. This is Inamorata, the last video that they've put out. I've been meaning to record and react to this song a little earlier and put up the video, but I've been getting over a bit of illness. I do apologize, but I've been very much down with the sickness. Nope, let's not do that. Anyway, this is Inamorata, which is Latin for female lover. Make of that what you will. Let's get into it. This is an 11 and a half minute song. Holy shucks. Oh. I love that voicing. Oh, gross. It's a dead wolf. Oh. Oh, thank God it's animated. Oh. Let's put the volume up. Volume up. Yeah. Oh. That is heavy as shit. Completely switch around. That sounds familiar. Oh no, he tripped and fell and broke his bottle. Looks like he escaped from somewhere. Okay. Welcome, won't you come inside? Meet the ghost where I reside. That's such a low riff. Oh no. Oh, what the hell is that? Lions are buying the need. Oh, I love that. Shedding and spreading the seed. Setting the trap with the prayer. I love the way that's written. Spinning the web. Misery. She needs me. Oh, but I need her more. Misery. She loves me. Misery. Oh, but I love her more. Misery. She kills me. Oh, but I end this war. Misery. She
my friend of misery.
That's awesome. What the fuck is that? Is that a fish? In the sky? What is happening? Yeah, no, follow the flying fish. Yeah. No, the Oasis is a lie. That's great. That's great. Oh, gross. She loves me. Oh, no. You're fucked, dude. That snake's about to swim up your ass. She kills me. Oh, shit. She feels me. Oh, no, but she's not what I'm living for. Oh, What the hell? Those were tits. That's an eye. Oh, yeah. Kirk has really brought the solos to this album, I feel. Way better than Hardwired. Oh, that was awesome. Okay, we're taking it down. Oh, yeah. Oh, this is beautiful.
She needs me, but I need her more. She loves me, but I love her more.
This is...
She kills me.
This is a very haunting, hauntingly beautiful section. Build it. Oh shit. You're fucked, buddy. It's Cthulhu! Yeah, that's straight up Cthulhu. Is this the next part in the saga? That's a James solo right there. That's a Hetfield solo. Yeah, that's a Hetfield solo right there. God damn, this song is awesome. This is an epic. Like, this is a full-on epic. Woo! Ruff. Oh. Oh no. Never trust the mirage of a beautiful woman in the desert. Don't trust it. That's the devil. Key change. Fucking key change. Just, yeah, because we can. Because fuck you, that's why. Gives me goosebumps. Oh shit.
She's not why I'm living. She's not why I'm
Yeah, okay, that's very symbolic.
She's not what I'm
Yes! The imagery. What? Double bass! Oh, wait. Oh, it's a fox. It's going to be the carcass of that guy, isn't it? Yeah, circle of life. Circle of life. Yep. That guy's been dead. Oh, what a beautiful fucking song. Oh my god. What? Dude, this had no right being that epic. That's an epic right there. It's like the It's not a ballad. It's not a heavy song. It's an epic. It told a story, literally. And by the video, yes, we understood the story. Guy's been dead. He's in hell, and he's just down on his luck. Bad luck after bad luck after bad luck. Being betrayed at the Oasis, the vultures, the fucking Cthulhu. Only to just wind up on the desert again because he's living an infinite loop. And then he's greeted by the beautiful face of Satan, who takes him by the arm and leads him off into infinity. But he's been dead this entire time. Now the fox coming back to life, and then I guess it's a circle of life, right? It's a loop. So the fox dies, deteriorates, comes back to life. Anyway, it can be an allegory for anything, really. Mental illness, drug abuse, what have you. But oh my God, this song, I heard literally straight out. I mean, yes, it's on the nose when the way he sang Misery takes you back to My Friend of Misery. Very similar voicings and all of that, but it had elements of Injustice for All. I heard a lot of Death Magnetic vibes on that, a lot of Load Reload vibes. It was just such a beautiful story that was told in this song. My goodness. 11 and a half minutes, and I loved every second. God damn it. But alas, we are at the end of the Metallica journey. No, not the Metallica journey. That came out wrong. Not the Metallica journey. They're going to keep doing their shit. I mean, my journey to react to their album. Anyway, whatever. Never mind. Scratch it. I'm going to leave it in. I'm not going to edit that out. Anyway, yeah. Let me know what you guys thought about this song. I loved it. I like a long song as long as there's enough variety within it. And there was plenty of variety within this song. I love long songs. I love, you know, those long ballads. I love the long epics. Give it to me. I mean, if every song on the album's like that, then it's not really special. But this is special. And it was a great bookmark to end the album. Like, this is a story that is told. It's great. Again, let me know what you guys thought. And leave a comment below. Like, subscribe, all that good stuff. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. You have a good day, and I'll see you in the next one. I don't really know what I'm going to react to after this, but there's a lot of great music out there. And you can let me know. Leave a comment below. I remember seeing a comment in an earlier video of a suggestion of something to react to. I'll definitely get around to that. But leave a comment of artists, music videos in general that you'd like me to react to. Strange shit. Like, out there. It doesn't have to be similar to Metallica or anything. Like, anything. If the video is crazy, suggest it in the comments and I'll get around to it. Thank you so much. But that's going to do it for me. Y'all have a good day. And I will catch you next time. Bye-bye.